Deputy Chief of the French Air and Space Forces Frederic Parisot said the Rafale F5 variant was not only increased in sensor capacity and weaponry, but also other technologies. The aircraft will also have a range of advanced features and can match the world's best 4th and 5th generation aircraft, with Dassault fighters able to face stiff competition from Sweden's Saab Gripen E fighter jets, Eurofighter Typhoon and US F-35 5th generation aircraft. Dassault continues to improve existing models. The Rafale is a twin-engine fighter jet with a delta wing and canard design capable of air supremacy to nuclear deterrence missions. "It is a very complete standard that I would qualify as a major for the Rafale," summarized General Frederic Parisot, Major General of the Air and Space Forces, in the final issue of DSI, dedicated to combat aviation. However, and even if the future air combat system is supposed to take over by 2040, there's no question it stops there. From its conception, the Rafale has been designed with an incremental approach. "This will surpass the entry of NGF service in 2040, explained Mbaye, referring to the fighter aircraft on which SCAF is based. "By the early 2030s, the F5 standard will allow us to further enhance the Rafale's first entry capacity, with new sensors and weaponry, but also the capacity to communicate, collaborate and be interoperable," said General Parisot. "We must remain agile to benefit from the speed of technological development," he stressed. Regarding what capabilities will be available for the Rafale F5, General Parisot said that the contours of this standard have not yet been decided. However, he said, "In 15 years, the Rafale will have an impressive number of abilities, some of which we haven't imagined." And to recall that, within 15 years, the E switched from the F2 standard to the recently declared FAIR standard, fully operational, capable of conducting intelligence missions with the RECO and GNSL, to implementing the ASMP missile. The targets included tanks, armored vehicles, artillery emplacements, command centers and air defense systems, according to the Dassault Aviation website. Information about this new fifth-generation platform has continued to spread to the media in recent months, and we now have the most complete vision of this budget-friendly entrant into stealth competition. The capabilities, cost, and even the overall design of this new fighter are all subject to change before the jet starts after burning through production. Russia's struggling economy and limited defense budget all ensure that the country will not be able to fund the continued development, let alone production, of the Checkmate LTA alone, leaving the future of this combat program largely in the hands of foreign markets. Russian officials have claimed that they invited delegates from 65 countries to come to the event and take a closer look at the fighter for this particular purpose. According to today's announcement, UAC believes it could start delivering the new Checkmate fighters within 5.5 years, with the first fighter aircraft for testing scheduled for completion in 2023. Rostec officials estimate an order of 300 aircraft, although they did not specify whether that was the intent. Domestically, overseas, or entirely. If the Russians are to make the LTA Checkmate their first successful stealth fighter on the export market, they need to make this jet look capable, reliable and perhaps most importantly, affordable. All of the aircraft's automated supply chain systems and simplified maintenance processes get the highest billing alongside regular fighter aircraft rates. And while it is important to remember that this fighter is actively marketed, it is equally important to remember that Russia has a long and illustrious history of making high-tech claims. A new military, only for it to fail to live up to expectations, or even ever to materialize, after its initial announcement that made headlines. So, with a grain of salt the size of a baseball, let's dive into what the UAC says their new fighter can do, and why it matters to the future of Russia's ongoing gaze contest with the West. We have analyzed where the LTA Checkmate fits into Russian defense equipment and what is required to make the fighter operational.